Hello all, welcome to Ephatha. Jesus said, be open. Jesus Christ is revealed in every book of the Bible. The birth of Jesus, his life, the redemption of mankind by his death on the cross, and the resurrection were all prophecy by the prophets in the Old Testament. Let us look into the various prophecies related to the passion of Christ. Messiah would be betrayed by Judas for 30 silver coins. Psalm 41:9 says, even my bosom friend in whom I trusted, who ate of my bread, has lifted his heel against me. Zechariah 11:12. So they paid me 30 pieces of silver, and the Lord said to me, throw it to the potter, the handsome price at which they valued me. Messiah will be abandoned. Psalms 31:11. Because of all my enemies, I am the utter contempt of my neighbors and an object of dread to my closest friends. Those who see me on the street flee from me. Messiah will be silent before his accusers. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. Like a lamb that is led to the slaughter, and like a sheep that before its shearers is dumb, so he opened not his mouth. Isaiah 53:7. Messiah will be mocked and spat on. I offered my back to those who beat me, my cheeks to those who pulled out my beard. I did not hide my face from mocking and spitting. Isaiah chapter 50, verse 5 to 6. Messiah's hands and feet would be pierced. Dogs around me, a pack of villains encircles me. They pierce my hands and my feet. Psalms 22:16. Messiah will be crucified with criminals. In Isaiah 53:12, because he poured out his soul to death and was numbered with the transgressors, yet he bore the sin of many and made intercession for the transgressors. Messiah's thirst will be quenched with vinegar and gall. In Psalm 69:21 we see, they put gall in my food and give me vinegar for my thirst. Soldiers will cast lots for Messiah's clothing. They divide my clothes among them and cast lots for my garment, says Psalms 22:18. Jesus prays for his enemies. In return for my love, they accuse me, even as I make prayer for them, Psalms 109:4. Messiah's bones would not be broken and his side will be pierced. In Psalms 34:20 we see, he keeps all his bones, not one of them is broken. In Zechariah 12:10, and I'll pour out on the house of David and the inhabitants of Jerusalem a spirit of compassion and supplication, so that when they look on him whom they have pierced, they shall mourn for him. Messiah would be buried with the rich. In Isaiah 53:9 we see, and they made his grave with the wicked and with the rich man in his death, although he had done no violence and there was no deceit in his mouth. Thank you for listening, and you can watch similar videos on our channel, Ephatha Catholic.